My name is Kenji Satake. I'm a professor and director of Earthquake Research Institute. My research interest is giant earthquakes and tsunamis. Those giant earthquakes are important phenomena for the geological history of the Earth, but they are also important because they affect society. I'm in Jogashima, the southern tip of the Miura Peninsula, where we had a large earthquake in 1923. It caused tremendous fire damage in downtown Tokyo, but it also caused wide area coastal uplift in this region. Previous to 1923, we know that earthquake happened in 1703 from historical documents, but also evidence we found here. We also found evidence of even older earthquake that happened 1293 and 1495. So considering these four earthquakes in the past, the average recurrence interval is about 200 years. These earthquakes happened in the plate boundary where the stress is released periodically. Okay, this is a typical example of the fault. You can see the offset of geological layers. Such offset occurs suddenly. The shock waves are the seismic waves we feel. And for the amount of offset, in this case, is only 20 centimeters or so. But for the Great Kanto earthquake, this offset is as large as several meters. This building was built in 1894. And in this building, there's an instrument called tide gauge. During the 1923 earthquake, this tide gauge recorded the sudden uplift of the land or drop of the sea level by 1.4 meters. If the sea level had changed by 1 meter suddenly, the scenery would be very different. You can see the people in fishing or canoeing, they'll see the ocean level will be 1 meter lower. Here we see white stuff. These are fossil mollusks. Mollusks live in sea level, but this is about 1 meter higher than the sea level, which indicates that this area has uplifted by about 1 meter during the 1923 Kanto earthquake. If you look at higher, you see another line of mollusk, which indicates the past uplift. And we know that this is associated with 1703 earthquake occurred in this region. In this bay, we use a special boat equipped with instrument that allows us to sample from the seafloor. This is a geological sample we obtained here. This is seafloor, and what you see is 1.8 meter long sample below seafloor. We usually have very fine materials deposited here or here, but you also find some coarse materials, including some small stone and some shells. These are brought by tsunamis occurred in this region, indicating the history of past Kanto earthquake. Until 10 years ago, we knew only about 1923 and 1703 Kanto earthquake. In the last 10 years or so, we found evidence of 1495 and 1293 earthquakes. In the future, we'd like to find more concrete evidence of those four earthquakes, and I hope to find evidence of even older earthquakes.